Thursday, President Biden will convene a virtual climate summit. He's hoping to attract dozens of world leaders. Putin and Xi Jinping have been invited. The word is, our president will go big. He will promise a 50% cut in CO2 emissions by America by 2030. Now, that's a much bigger cut than Obama promised. Biden believes that by leading, he will make China do more to cut emissions. Good luck with that. China's emissions are going up big time. They're building new coal-fired power plants right now, which will produce enough electricity to supply the whole of Germany. Under the Paris climate deal, they don't have to do anything in terms of CO2 reductions. They don't have to do anything at all until 2030. And asked if China would jump in now to cut emissions, an official said, "That's not very realistic," end quote. He's got it right. It's very doubtful that Biden can persuade Xi to rein in China's industrial dominance. But we Americans, oh no, we got to keep on sacrificing. We have to cut. We have to kill fossil fuel jobs. We have to pay others to help them handle climate. Even though America has already cut emissions more than any other industrial country, we have to endure the pain while others make empty promises. Did you know that in 2019, America's CO2 emissions dropped all the way back to 1992 levels? Nobody else has done that. But the Green New Deal is the centerpiece of Biden's agenda, so we must keep sacrificing in the name of saving the planet. You can thank Bernie Sanders, AOC, Senator Markey, and all the other climate warriors for this. They push Biden out onto his climate limb. They'll demand that we keep on sacrificing. And China? Who knows what they'll say in public, but in private, is there any doubt? They're laughing at us.